What's up, guys, and welcome back to Gabe Miller Music. Today I am showing you the making of an all virtual instrument metal track, and I think it actually kind of worked. So a little bit of background before I get into this. I've been a drummer for pretty much all of my life, and along with that has come a pet obsession, a sweet spot for metal, especially stuff that has a lot of kind of drum work and a lot of rhythmic elements. So up front, this is going to be very much in the kind of djent progressive-ish style. So if that's not your bag, I totally understand, but that is what you're in for. So basically, I've been wanting to make metal for a while, so I got this guitar plugin that's actually quite good, as you probably heard in the intro, and a drum plugin, and just decided to go for it. Started writing some riffs, some drum parts, and before I knew it, I've got a little three-song kind of metal meets cyberpunk synthwave EP going here. So, wanted to walk through the track and kind of show the making of a metal track from an electronic music producer's perspective. So, to kick things off, the big thing that I focused on this track is taking one simple little melodic idea and then taking that to its furthest possible conclusion. Everything is built around this tiny little synth lick, and that just loops ad nauseum through pretty much the whole song, because over here it's very apparent with all the plucks and such, and then later on in this kind of verse section I have the bass doing it as well. So real quick, I want to talk through the plugins I'm using here before I get into the layering. So the guitar and bass are being simulated by Shreddage 2, and then Shreddage 2 bass or Shreddage bass or something like that. It's a contact instrument. It's kind of expensive, but it was worth it to me because basically it allows me to be a one-man metal band with a lot of musical training, but not a ton of guitar training. I can play a bit of guitar, but not to this level. So this is what it sounds like on its own. And let me take off the amp sim. So this is what a Shreddage looks like. And the way this works, it's all MIDI. And if you have it set to a very low velocity, it's a palm mute. And then later on, you'll actually hear some proper chords. Basically, if I take this note and pitch it down, you get a power chord. And then the amp sim is Grind Machine. This is a decently inexpensive amp simulator, and it sounds quite nice. So you got your palm mutes there, and that's nice and beefy, which is lovely. And then we got the bass, really low. Yeah, Shreddage bass too. This is basically as low as it goes. I believe this guitar is in drop G, and so the bass is following suit, so you get this just ridiculously low bass going on, and no other processing on that, that's just DI. So, together. One thing I have learned that is kind of a key to getting really beefy guitars is a really beefy bass to go under it. That typically goes a long way in making that work. The drums. This is a free plugin called MT Power Drumkit 2, and it's pretty good. It sounds pretty nice. Got a nice punch everywhere. All the cymbals that you want. China. Two crashes. Toms. All that. And this is where my experience as a drummer does come in handy, because even though I'm not playing this on a drum kit, I do have the sensibilities of what a drummer actually would play, so I'm able to program something that not only is physically playable, but actually sounds like something I would play in real life. Minus the double kick. My footwork is not that strong. I can do quite a bit with one foot, but I've never really taken the time to learn how to do stuff with both feet. If I ever get another drum kit, that's something I would definitely spend a lot of time teaching myself, because I would love to be able to play all of this in real life. They just have a compressor on there. And then for the second half of this section, the melody going again. And those are kind of the main elements, and then moving forward. Drop out the guitars entirely, just have the bass doing its thing. This kind of nice groove between the drums and the bass. And then this is decently synth-centric, because in my brain, this is like the soundtrack to some sort of futuristic world, almost. And I do have this doubled up with a lead guitar. And a nice chugging guitar going on here. And that's on actual chords. Lots of palm muting here. And of course, before your breakdown, the classic boom. And here I have an actual pitch bend. So it goes. Fully leaning into the djent element here, and I know it's dumb and over the top, but that was a lot of fun to write. All right, moving on to the next track on the EP, and if you'd like to listen to any of the full songs, you can click a link in the description, listen to them with your ears if you are at all inclined to do so. So this one, I did a couple of different things. A lot of the setup is the same, but the big thing about this song is the time signature. So as a drummer, I really do enjoy syncopation, unusual time signatures, stuff that just plays with rhythm. So that does naturally attract me to djent and progressive metal. And so this track is in 7/8. So that lends itself to some kind of different rhythms that otherwise I wouldn't have come up with, since most electronic music is in 4/4. Channeling my inner Daft Punk writing Tron music here. And real quick, I will go into what these elements are. It's kind of brass element. These are all serum patches, by the way. Pad, which is quite nice. Percussive pluck, that guy's doing a lot of the work. And then when you get into the full riff, once again, I'm well aware that you could play most of that riff with one hand, but rhythmically I think it's kind of fun and something a little different from what I'd normally write. And this is the main thing, is just getting me outside my comfort zone and getting me running something a little different from what I normally make. So, you know. Got the synth and the lead layered up here. A lot of stuff going on here with the drums. I made sure that every little repeat of that beat has something a little bit different in it, because a real drummer is not going to play the exact same thing every single time. You know, you're naturally, as a human being, going to just vary it up a little bit. So I tried to reflect that in the way I program the drums. And I have little things like these little ghost hits. Stuff like that really goes a long way towards humanizing these very quantized beats. And then also making sure that this is something that a drummer with two arms and no more arms can play. So when I go for that crash, there's no hi-hat here. Because a classic mistake made by people who are programming drums with no drum knowledge is that they'll program a drum part that can only be played by an octopus, and unless you can teach an octopus to play the drums, probably best to do something that sounds like a human. Once again, palm mutes. I like palm muted guitars. Once again, leaning more percussive than melodic here. And then, once again, some nice pads. And finally, that goes back into the main riff. All right, one more track here, and this is the one where I really merged the electronic and metal worlds, because I started off with this loop here. Take off the processing. And this is just a little loop from a sample pack of stuff made on modular synths, probably kind of a randomly generated sort of thing. And this immediately caught my ear because of the rhythm. So first of all, I had a little processing. Bit crusher doing quite a bit here. And that immediately suggested a riff to go with it, which is, well, I'll start with the drums. And then from there, since this is in the djent style, the guitar just follows the kick. With the alternating open string and palm muting. Pinch harmonic, because I can. And then in the second half, it actually goes into chords, so. So it all works around that one little rhythm, and there's quite a bit more I did here that I'm getting to in a second, but one other cool thing is this build-up here. Basically, that's this filtered way down, then pan to the right. So it gets you used to the sound of the guitar, introduces the riff, shows how the riff is connected to the percussion loop, and then when everything kicks in, it's that much more powerful. Because suddenly it's in both ears, and suddenly it's in the full frequency spectrum and all that, and I thought that was kind of dope. So, moving on. Moving back into syncopation territory here. Once again, following the loop, but in a bit of a different way, in a bit of a different rhythm. This is probably the fakest sounding part, is this lead right here. That's the layer to the lead. But it's fine. It's alright. Right. So going a bit melodic, and then we go back into rhythmic, and this is where I really go crazy with the kind of metal meets electronic. Kind of channeling my inner Carpenter Brute here, so got a bunch of these serum patches. I think there's a couple of Virtual Riot presets and then a couple of stock presets in there. Layered with this. So almost more electro house, dark synth wave kind of thing. Taking it out of the realm of metal and into the realm of electronic. And then this fill. Then building up for a breakdown, going back into pure djent. So that about does it for the track walkthroughs. I thought it would be interesting to get an electronic music producer's perspective on making metal, and show how one would make metal using nothing but virtual instruments and try to get it to actually sound good. And once again, I am very well aware that there are many different subgenres of metal, and this is just picking on a very specific one and kind of ripping off the stereotypes of it at that. However, this was mostly an experiment for me, and hopefully at least somewhat interesting for you guys. So, thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to hear any of the full tracks, you can check down in the description, and I'll be back with a new video next week. Peace.